Assalamu alaikum students, how are you? I hope that you will be fine and enjoying your summer vacations nicely at your homes. Students, today we are going to solve the skill booster pack of the level 8 of the subject science, and the page number that we are going to solve today is 23. So students, at this page we have to find the reason on the base of which we have to label the parts which are shown here. Question number 7. Name the kind of cell division that is taking place in the following diagrams. So students, here we have in the A and the B part the diagrams of the kinds of the cell division, but on the base of the particular reason and understanding the diagrams carefully, we have to label that A part shows which kind of cell division and B part shows which kind of cell division, and then we write down the names of the cell division in the space which is provided here. So students, moving on to the A part first. Students, in the A part, the diagram which is shown is showing the complete meiosis, which is a kind of the cell division. Students, meiosis is a type of cell division which occurs only within the reproductive organs, means within the sex cells of the body. So students, meiosis is a type of division in which the 4 haploid daughter cells with half the number of chromosomes will be produced from the parent cell. So it is also called as the reduction phase. Students, you can see here we have the parent consisting of the 4 chromosomes, and in the result we have the 4 haploid daughter cells from that parent cell, so we called it as a reduction phase. So students, now we discuss the explanation of the various forms which are shown here. Students, the chromosomes during the cell division will become thicker and shorter, and they will become visible. So there is a phase called interphase in which the chromosome prepare themselves for the cell division, and they will also form pairs, means the similar chromosome will form pairs with each other, so these pairs are called the homologous chromosomes, and these homologous chromosome will also get replicated during the interphase. And this is the meiosis 1. Meiosis is divided into the 2 phases. The first is meiosis 1, and after that will be the meiosis 2. In the meiosis 1, the various phases will take place, but the final result will be the daughter cells 2 haploid will be produced. From that, one cell having the homologous chromosomes pairs. So this is called meiosis 1, in which the chromosomes will get separated from each other during the telophase. So students, after meiosis 1, the meiosis 2 will take place, and that meiosis 2 consisting of the 4 haploid set of chromosomes. The one daughter nuclei which will be produced as a result of the meiosis 1 will be giving us the 2 haploid another set of the chromosomes. And this is also in the same in the other haploid set, which will also give us another 2 sets of haploid daughter chromosomes. Students, one thing that is also obvious from this type of division, that homologous chromosomes have now exchanged their segments and their parts with each other. So this type of cell division which produces the variation in the next generation. As you can see here, we have started with this parent cell having no any sort of variation, but in the haploid sets of the daughter chromosome we have seen that every daughter cell is different from another on the base of the various variations. So this is all about the meiosis, which consisting of the two phases, meiosis 1 and the meiosis 2. So we will write here the type of cell division which is shown here is a meiosis. The next, moving on to the B part, students, the kind of cell division which is shown here is a mitosis. How it is a mitosis? You can see here that it is starting from a single cell containing, which is a parent cell containing the diploid number of chromosome. Diploid number of chromosome is a normal set of chromosomes having the two chromosomes. And in the daughter cells that are produced are exactly like that of the parent cell, having the same number of chromosome as were present in the parent cell. So students, what happened in the mitosis? Mitosis take place in all the other cells of the body except that of the reproductive cells. So during the mitosis, the chromosomes will enter into the phase which is called the interphase, and in that phase they will get prepared themselves for the cell division, and in that phase they will become visible, thick, short, and they will also get replicated. So students, here we have the replication of these two chromosomes which were present in the parent cells. And after that, these replicated chromosomes attach themselves on the middle of the cell. So students, the chromatids, the arms of the chromosomes, attach with the spindle fibers of the cell to form the metaphase plate. So students, then after attachment, the pulling of the chromatid take place, in which will contract the chromosome and pull the chromosomes towards the opposite poles. And when the pulling start and they reach their poles, the cell will be divided into the two types. Or two types contains the same number of chromosome as the parent cell, and there is no variation in the mitosis. The cell from which we have started the mitosis will be the same of the cells that are produced at the end of the mitosis. So this is a mitosis, which is a kind of cell division. So we write here the mitosis. So students, that is all about our today's lecture. I hope that you clearly understand of both the cell divisions. Allah Hafiz.